talk to you.
What's the matter with your phone?
In person.
Now is not a good time.
Trevor, please, it's important. I have to tell you what Adam's done. Brooke, I'm sorry. I didn't realize you had company.
No, it's all right. It's, you two need privacy.
No. Stick around. Mrs. Chandler won't be staying too long.
Trevor, please, it's important.
No, it's all right. Look, I need to change my clothes anyway, so I'll go home and do that, and I'll meet you at McKay's in, say, half an hour.
No, sweetheart, I wish you would stay.
No, it's all right.
Thank you, Brooke.
You're welcome. See you in a little, huh?
Mm-hmm. Why don't you call before you come busting over here?
I'm sorry.
Okay. What's so important that you need to bust up my date?
I don't know where to begin. I'm so furious, I don't even know how I got over here.
Furious at your ever-loving husband?
You're not going to believe this. Or maybe you will, but I am having trouble believing it.
What am I not going to believe? Come on, tell me.
I feel like such a total fool.
Well, are you going to let me in on it or not?
Adam tricked me into signing over a large portion of my holdings.
Signing over to him? What do you mean he tricked you?
Well, running the foundation, there's so much to do. There is so much paperwork. It's so time-consuming and so many distractions. And every day he hands me a stack of papers to sign.
Who signed?
Little by little, he's been getting me to give over my assets.
How did you find out about it?
Sky, actually, was the one who found out, and then she came to see me.
Well, I hate to say I told you so.
I know.
So if you're coming over here for sympathy, you came to the wrong address.
I don't know what to do.
Well, I can't arrest them, if that's what you're hoping. I suggest you see a lawyer.
Are you saying I have no rights?
No, I'm saying you should find out what your rights are. Maybe, you should talk to Jackson Montgomery. I gotta get dressed or I'm gonna be late for my date.
Oh, I guess I deserve this.
What?
You want to know why I came over here? I thought I owed it to you to hear me say you were right. Adam only married me for my money, and now he's got his hands on it. Congratulations.
Do you know where he is?
No message. Thank you.
Hi.
Stuart.
I was just thinking about you and wondering how you were doing.
Okay.
Really? You look a little down.
Well, I did it. I told Natalie everything Daddy was doing.
Oh, boy. How'd she take it?
She was pretty stunned.
Yeah. How about your father?
I don't know. I haven't spoken to him yet. But after I blew the whistle on Daddy, I went to tell Will all about it. And in the middle of it, Palmer walked in.
Oh, boy. What happened?
Well, Will really didn't have a choice. He told him the truth. Whew.
Well, that's good, because now everything's out in the open, right?
No, Uncle Stuart, that's not good. It's not. You see, Palmer kicked Will out of the house, and now Will is mad at me. And I'm sure when Daddy finds out what I've done, he's going to be mad at me, too. Blow my whole world apart.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I knew what I was doing.
Yeah, but you shouldn't be punished for doing the right thing.
How come, if it's the right thing, why do I feel like I still let everybody down?
You didn't let anybody down. Adam and Will let you down.
You know what's even worse?
What?
I want to drink so bad.
But you know that that's not going to help.
No, I know. Don't worry. I haven't had one. It's just so tempting.
Well, what can I do to help? Could I take you to an AA meeting?
Oh, thanks, but I already called my sponsor, and I'm going to go see her.
Okay. Well, how about a lift?
goes and take a cab.
No!
Oh, forget about a cab. Come on, get your coat. Come on.
So basically, I'm out in the cold.
What about Sky?
It's her fault I'm in this fix.
Come on, I thought you just said you loved her.
I do, but I begged her not to say anything.
Well, I mean, how could she not? What Adam is doing is absolutely terrible. And I think it took a lot of courage for her to go and tell Natalie.
Thanks to that courage, I'm cut off.
I'm sorry.
And I've lost Sky.
Well, it's none of my business, but whose fault is that?
Look, Will, maybe you should just go to her, okay? I mean, go make up, you know,
there's
and apologize.
There's no point.
Well, I thought you just said you loved her.
So I don't have anything to offer her.
Offer your love.
You've read too many romance novels. See, when you love somebody, you want to offer them a whole world.
Not everybody needs the world, though, Will. Not Sky, anyway.
Well, I understand, and I sympathize. You realize none of this would happen if your uncle had stayed out of his life.
Ted, don't start with me, okay?
But we know your uncle can't stay out of anybody's life. I mean, your sister and I have been through this many times.
I know, and that's why I was hoping you could help me out.
Me?
Yeah, you could talk to Uncle Palmer.
Oh, I can't talk to Paul. It's his honeymoon, for crying out loud.
No, but when he gets back, you could tell him that I should be able to date anybody that I please, and that my personal life and my performance at work they have nothing to do with each other. Would you do that for me, kiddo?
Look, Will, I really want to help you. I mean, I really do, but there's just so much more to consider here than just your romance.
Dixie, please.
I'm going to give you kids a couple minutes alone. I need to get some air.
Ted, you sure you don't mind?
Not at all. Walk would do me good anyway.
Okay, thanks. Hey, though, if you stop by the case.
Yeah, I know. Pick up a plate of ice cream.
Then you better make it chocolate. You know what they say about chocolate, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Well, you'll go great with that cake anyway.
Okay, you got it, sweet. Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye.
See
love you.
Well?
Well, about Uncle Palmer.
I'm only asking to talk to him.
Are you still planning to take over his business?
And what does that have to do with anything?
Because, I mean, I'm not going to exactly go rushing to your defense if you still are, if that's still your goal. So you got to tell me, you got to promise me that you'll give up that idea.
You don't even sound surprised.
Adam craves power, and for him, power is synonymous with money. No, I'm not surprised. I just wish he'd find a more ethical way of building an empire. I mean, after the stroke,
what,
I thought he'd
changed. What, did you figure you could straighten him out?
Oh, no. I washed my hands of Adam a long time ago. I mean, if somebody else wants to step in and try and reform him, that's great, but I already gave.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It's just like me and Natalie. I mean, it's got the nerve to come to me after when something goes sour. I mean, what does she expect from me?
Could it be that she simply wants some sympathy?
I'll send her a card. I want my card on my sleeve for that thing. She rips it off. She stomps all over. Now she wants me to rescue her.
You should give her a break. You know, she admitted she made a mistake. I don't think that was easy for her to do.
Oh, it's too bad. Natalie loves money. She married Adam for it. She's getting exactly what she deserves.
Well, my, aren't we tough and hard-boiled?
Look, I am just as sensitive as the next guy. If Natalie screws up, I feel real sorry for her. What am I supposed to do?
Maybe a little more understanding. Can I make a suggestion?
It's free country, babe. Shoot away.
You put your pride aside and you admit how you really feel about her.
But I already told you how I feel about her.
No. She hurt you and you want to get even.
Well, come on, Brooke. I'm not that kind of a guy.
We're all like that when somebody hurts us. I think you should think about it. Do you really want Natalie out of your life? I mean, or is this just hostility because you have a bruised male ego?
Look, I think you said enough here.
Trevor, look, I'm just a friend, all right? I don't want to see you throw something away that you're going to regret later.
Okay, I heard you.
It's not a matter of just hearing. It's a matter of doing something. I think that you should go and see Natalie right now.
I want to show you why my Dirt Devil is the world's best-selling corded hand vacuum.
Okay, Seth.
You've been carrying this hatred for far too long. And look, Will, if Mama were still alive, she'd be the first to point that out.
If it weren't for him, Mama would still be alive. And how do you don't know what you'd feel.
I do know that she loved Uncle Palmer. And I know that Uncle Palmer made a lot of mistakes and he tried to make up for neglecting her. You gotta admit he's done a lot for us. No, he has. Have you forgotten what it was like back then? What it was like growing up in Pigeon Hollow? He gave you a job, an education. He sent you to college. He brought Lainey to Pine Valley. He's educating her, too. He's even accepted Ted and me.
What do you just want? What do you expect me to do? Just forget how he treated her?
Quill, you can't change the past. And you can't bring Mama back. Uncle Palmer has made mistakes. All right, and he's admitted them, and he's tried to make up for them. But you can't change things. And you gotta stop beating this whole thing to death.
Yeah, well, maybe you can. But I can't.
Well, if you think revenge and hatred would make Mama happy, then you don't remember her. And if you want me to help you with Uncle Palmer, then you have to let go of the past.
So you've turned your back on me, too. Fine.
Will, I haven't turned my back on you. Will!
Oh, Mrs. Chandler.
I thought this was your night off.
Well, I just got back a few minutes ago and I saw the lights. I wanted to make sure everything was all right.
Yes, everything's fine. I just went for a walk and ended up here. It's a nice place to be quiet, I think.
It's a little chilly, though. Would you like a pot of hot tea?
That's very sweet of you. No, I really don't want a thing.
Oh, well, then, I'll leave you to your thoughts, then.
Winifred, would you mind keeping an ear out for Timothy? He was sleeping when I left, just in case he wakes up.
Don't worry about a thing.
Thank you.
Good night, Mrs. Chandler.
Good night.
Betty, those brownies.
You sweet talker, Betty Crocker. All the sweet things you do with those brownies. And...
Hi.
Stuart, hi.
Can I talk to you for a minute?
Is everything okay?
Adam has done something real bad.
I know that, Stuart. You mustn't let it upset you.
But he's hurting people all over again. He's my brother.
Stuart, you can't stop him, all right? I know it's hard, but it's not your responsibility.
You don't think he's ever going to change, do you?
No, I don't. I think it's less and less likely.
I really don't believe that. I think he can learn to be a better person.
Stuart.
If you would just come back to him.
Please don't say that, okay?
Believe me, it's true. He loves you so much. If he would do anything for you.
Stuart, I know that you love him. I know that you want to help him, but I am not his salvation. I mean, you forget I was married to him, and it didn't stop him from lying and cheating then, so why would it stop him now? And we have talked about this before.
I know, but...
You have to realize, all right, that Adam will only change if he wants to change, and I am afraid that Adam likes the way he is just fine.
Are you mad at me?
Oh, no, Stuart, I'm not mad at you. I just don't want you to be upset, okay? I don't want you to take Adam's behavior on yourself. You're not your brother's keeper. We all have to let go of the past, okay?
Oh, hi, Ted.
Hi. Hi.
cold out here. You want to invite me in?
How did you know where I was?
I saw one of you come down here. I figured you'd be here. You all right?
I guess after everything that's happened, I'm okay.
You here on account of Adam? Are you afraid of him?
No. Adam's in New York on business. He won't be back until tomorrow.
So you haven't talked to him yet?
No. Why are you here, Trevor?
I'm worried about you, Nat.
I'm sorry I spoiled your date.
You didn't spoil my date. In fact, Brooke convinced me to come over here and talk to you.
Why would she do that?
She said I wasn't being understanding enough, and she was right. So, here I am, doll.
You don't make this easy.
Neither do you. You talked to an attorney yet?
No.
What's the problem?
I'm a little ashamed. How could I have let myself be taken in by him? I'm ashamed to admit what a fool I am.
You're not the first thing this has happened to, and you've talked to me, so...
That was different.
Why?
At least I thought it was different.
You need legal advice, doll, and you better get it fast. You get it fast enough, you can salvage something before Adam finds out you're wise to him.
Why would you even care?
Why? You know, I don't give bupkis for money. And obviously, you do. And I figure if some guy is robbing you, like... shouldn't get away with it.
No, he shouldn't.
So do something. Don't be a helpless victim. I wish you luck. I gotta go.
Trevor, wait.
There I was, about to make my theatrical debut. My parents waited, my teacher prodded.
Play!
Blank Motors.
General Motors.
Have some fun with Tina and Gabrielle.
Ooh, she's bad. She's really bad.
Join us on Match Game. Oh, this week.
Tony becomes a fireman.
I'm sorry, ma'am. You're coming with me.
Well, it's about time.
No, it's okay. I should be getting home. I don't like to leave Skylar alone too long.
Listen, give me my love, will you?
I will. Bye, Brooke.
Bye, Stuart.
Take care. You sure I can't buy another cup of coffee?
Oh, no, thanks.
Your ice cream will be ready in just a minute, Mr. Martin.
Thanks, Anne. There's no hurry.
Okay.
So, what are you doing out by yourself?
Excuse me?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did that sound sexist?
A little. I'm a big girl. I do go out by myself.
I'm sorry. That's not what I meant. All I meant was that I... Come on. You know what I meant. I want you to be okay.
I am. Honest.
Why is this so hard?
I don't know, but it is.
Am I making it worse? Am I being here?
No. Look, I'm not gonna lie to you. I admit, I miss you. I miss you a lot. But believe it or not, I am going to get over you.
Hundreds have. See, that was good. That was you laughed. I like that. I miss that.
Yeah, we used to laugh a lot.
Yeah, we did.
So I think we're doing okay. I mean, we're able to talk and we're able to laugh, and maybe eventually, maybe we'll even be good friends again.
I want nothing more in the entire world. You mean a hell of a lot to me. You got me through a lot of rough spots.
You helped me too.
Here we are, one double chocolate fudge.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Here, get the change.
Well, thank you.
Sure. Well.
You should go before it melts.
I'm glad I ran into you. Oh, I forgot to ask you. How'd you do at the bowling alley?
145, first try.
145?
Mm-hmm. Trevor claims it's beginner's luck.
He doesn't know the half of it. Trevor Dillon hasn't discovered yet how amazing you truly are. 145. It's bizarre.
I don't want you to leave.
You said you weren't afraid.
I'm not.
Well, there's nothing more I can do, Natalie.
I just want you to be here. You were right about so many things.
You're right about Adam.
You were right about me, too.
I lost you there.
How many times have you told me I still had feelings for you?
A lot.
What happened on the island between us? I didn't forget that. You remember when you told me that you think about it all the time? So do I.
What are you driving at?
I love you, Trevor. I never stopped loving you.
Then why? I mean, Natalie, you...
Just wanted you to know how I feel. Whether or not you return those feelings doesn't matter. What matters is that I'm through lying to you and I am through lying to myself. That's all. That's all I wanted to say.
Natalie?
Send your children in the right direction, a parent's guide to the art of map making.
Also, John Cleese and Barbara Walters tomorrow on...